Hi, this is Gary with MacMost Now. On today's episode, let's talk about deleting photos from iPhoto. So I very often get questions about deleting photos from iPhoto because sometimes it can be tricky if you don't understand the difference between events and albums. So here in iPhoto, in your library, you have different selections starting with events. So events basically have individual photos in them. Every photo is in at least one event and exactly one event, no more. Now people like to create albums, and albums are listed down here where you can create albums and put photos in them. And you could put photos in many different albums or not have a photo in any albums at all. So the difference between events and albums is very important when you're trying to do something like delete photos. An album really doesn't have any photos in it at all. Albums are just basically list of links like bookmarks in a browser or a playlist in iTunes. It just links to different photos that may be found in different events. So for instance, I can create an album called Scenery and link to different photos that have something to do with scenery or whatever I want. And these could be in all sorts of different albums, or different events rather. In events, basically, an event is kind of like a roll of film in the old-fashioned metaphor. You have different photos grouped together, usually from the time you took them, and every photo is in exactly one event, and it's only in one event. Now, if you're looking at events and you want to delete a photo, it's very easy. You can go into an event, you can select a photo like this one, and you can delete it by going to Photos and Move to Trash, or Command and Delete is the shortcut. And when you do so, it'll make sure that it's what you want to do, and it sticks it here in the trash. In the trash, you can see it's there. And I can actually go into trash and treat it like a normal photo, like in an album, but it's in the trash album rather than anywhere else, and I can put it back, basically undo it. So if I go back to the event, it's there. So deleting photos from events, very simple and straightforward. Now, if you go into an album, like under scenery or animals here, I've got the same photo, and if I select to delete it, you can see that the Command D shortcut, this menu choice here, is now removed from album, no longer put in the trash. So what will happen, and it will even warn me, is it will say, do you want to remove the selected photo from the album? So I'll say remove the photo. It's no longer in the album. If I go back to the event where I know the photo is, you can see the photo is still there in the event, just no longer in this album. And it also doesn't affect other albums. So for instance, let's undo that. So we put it back there. And let's go back to the event, and I can stick that same photo under scenery. So now I look in scenery, I see that picture there, and I see the same picture there under animals. I select it and Command Delete. Remove the photo. You can see it's still under scenery there. And of course it's still under its event. The photo really isn't deleted at all. I've just simply removed it from that one album. So let's undo that, and we can see it's back in those two albums. So how do you delete photos completely if you're just looking at them in an album? Well, the easy answer is you never delete photos from an album. You remove them from an album and they'll be gone from that album. And if you really want to delete them, like you want to get rid of them forever, you go into the event and you delete it from the event. However, sometimes people go and fill up an album with photos they want to delete. So say I want to delete all of these photos here under scenery. I just want to get rid of them. I could go and select one, I could control click on it and say show event, and now it goes into the event that has that photo, select the photo and delete it. But that could be a lot of work if I have a ton of photos I want to delete. So there is one other trick. You can select all, Command A to select all, in this album, and you can go to event and create an event. And what will happen here is basically it will move all of the photos from their original events into a new event. And it warns you about it here. Since photos can only be in one event at a time, it will remove them from all the events that they're in, could be spread out through the entire library, put them in one single event. Once they're in that one single event, you can then go to that single event and delete them from that event, thus deleting them completely from your library. Now, another way to do that without creating an album is say you want to go through events or photos, which is basically a list of events as well. It's just that it lists them in a way that you can see photos across multiple events. So say I want to select a lot of different photos to delete. I could select them here and select another one holding the Command key down. So I'm selecting multiples across multiple albums and then hit Command Delete to put them in the trash. But say I want to review them all first. what I could do instead is flag them. So flagging basically creates a special album here. It's very easy to flag. You can click the little flag there at the top. There's a real easy way to do it inside of here. It's Command Period or this menu item. So I can go through using the arrow keys and flag different photos that I want to delete. And now if I go to my flagged photos, I see that they're all listed here. And it's the same deal here as if this was in an album. I can't delete them from here. If I hit delete, it simply unflags it. So what I can do instead is I can select all of these and do the same thing here where I create an event. I can actually don't even have to select them all. I can say create event from flagged photos. So basically remove them all from their current events, put them in a new event, and from there I can delete the event, thus deleting all the photos. So you can use flagging, then create new event, and then delete the event to delete photos, kind of with a review process of your own in the middle. And of course, if you do decide to delete photos, notice that let's go in there into the events, and you can see there's the new photos I've created, this untitled event here, and I can command delete it, and you can see that they appear under trash. So I still have the ability to undo what I've done here at the last minute. I can put them back right there, and I can select multiple ones and there's put back right here. So I have a chance to undo it, or I can control click on trash to empty trash. You could also just go to iPhoto, empty iPhoto trash, and there's even a shortcut for it. Another thing you may want to do is actually to archive photos that you're deleting. Maybe you just want to delete them from your iPhoto library and you want to archive them somewhere, like burn them to a DVD or stick them on an old external drive. So you can basically go into your flagged photos there just before you go to delete them, or go into the album just before you delete them, drag and drop them into a folder, and you can see now these photos are stored there, copies of them stored there. So now I can delete them knowing that I've got copies there as backups. So I hope you found this look at deleting photos from iPhoto useful. Till next time, this is Gary with MacMost Now. Want more video tutorials? Just go to MacMost.com, click on the videos link at the top of the page, and then you can view all of the hundreds of MacMost videos by category.